Because the shoulder joint has such a large range of motion, it is less stable than other joints, making it more commonly dislocated in sports. Inside the shoulder, the bones are held together, similar to a golf ball sitting on a tee. The head of the humerus is the ball, and the cup-like glenoid is the golf tee. The edge of the tee is a rubbery ring called the labrum that adds extra support to the joint. The shoulder is held securely in place by the ligaments, capsule, and muscles that surround the joint. Whenever these structures are weak or injured, shoulder instability and dislocation can occur. Shoulder dislocation is a common injury in contact sports. If enough force is applied to the shoulder when the arm is in a vulnerable position, the humerus or ball can pop out from the shoulder socket. This is called a shoulder dislocation. The ball can fall forwards, backwards, or downwards. The most common dislocation is when the ball falls forward, injuring the labrum and surrounding muscles and ligaments. With severe dislocations, not only is the labrum torn, but the humeral head collides with the edge of the cup, denting the ball. Shoulder dislocations are typically very painful, and if a medical professional is present when it happens, they may be able to put it back in place while at the field, before the muscles spasm. If not, it is typically necessary to have it put back in at the emergency room, where the muscles can be relaxed with medicine. To confirm the degree of your shoulder injury, you'll need a specialist to examine your shoulder. The experts at the Sports Medicine Center at Children's Hospital Colorado will perform a physical exam and use imaging like X-ray and MRI to evaluate the severity of the injury. For less severe dislocations, adequate rest and physical therapy is needed to heal the shoulder injury. For severe dislocations with more damage, surgery is frequently the best option. Your physician will help determine the best choice for you. You'll be asleep during the surgery with general anesthesia and given a nerve block to minimize pain after the surgery. To begin the surgery, several small incisions are created for the instruments and the camera. Once inside, the surgeon will examine your shoulder for any damage and address it as needed. The torn labrum is freed from the edge of the bone where it is trying to heal in a poor position. The bone is prepared. Sutures are placed around the labrum and through the capsule. Holes are created. The sutures are pulled through the anchors. Then the labrum is pulled into the correct position and held in place with the anchors. If the dent in the ball is too large, the surgeon may fill it with local tissue. An anchor is placed in the ball, and the local tissue is pulled tight into the dent. The surgeon will test to make sure your shoulder is stable before the surgery is finished. After surgery, you will be in an arm brace that always stays on except during physical therapy and bathing. 2 weeks later, you will begin physical therapy. After about 6 weeks, you can remove the brace. On average, our athletes return to non-contact sports after 5 to 6 months. For contact sports, it is typically 6 to 9 months, depending on your surgeon's discretion. For more information, visit the Children's Hospital Colorado website.